Hey guys, what's up? It's Vince V, the StarCraft 2 dude, and some people have been having a lot of trouble with Protoss lately. This is a good example replay of how to deal with Protoss. The first thing that I've been doing lately is I stay away from getting Zerglings, and the reason why I do that is because Zerglings, especially on this map, do not do well against Zealots. So I primarily decide to tech straight to Roaches. And then once the Protoss player commits to Stalkers, what I'll do is I will switch to Hydras. And then in order to counter Colossus, I will tend to make a few Corruptors, which you'll see in this video, or I decide to make some Infestors, which is the other way to go about doing it. So first thing to note is I am playing against a Protoss player. His name is Stevotron or Stevotron. And he's going to be doing a pretty typical wall in right here, leaving just a little bit of space right there for his zealots to come in and out and his stalkers to come in and out. This map is not considered a Zerg favored map because of the very short rush distance, and an all-in committed Protoss player can very easily overwhelm you with zealots. So that is why I pray that most of the time I can go ahead and get my roaches out quick enough to counter whatever they're going to be doing. You'll notice I had a 13 spawning pool and then followed it up with a quick extractor. The reason why I do that is because you do need a considerable amount of gas early on to get these roaches. Now, after the 2 supply nerf, my roach rollover strategy no longer works the way that I had talked about it. Take a look at the income tab. No longer works. All you need to do to compensate for one base roach is you are going to want to spawn 2 additional overlords before you spawn your first batch of roaches. Now, a lot of players recently have been getting a spawning pool over here and getting a Roach Warren or their other building over here. Now, I like that because it's, provides a little bit more defense for your drones, but at the same time, putting the buildings back here will allow for your opponent to not scout you quite as easily. Now, he goes for a very standard gateway to cybernetics core with 2 pylons, very standard build order. But the interesting thing that he's going to do is now once he scouts my Roach Warren, he's going to know I'm going for roaches, and I know that he's not going for anything special. The reason why I decided not to scout him with a drone in this game is because on this particular map, you need all the economic advantage you can possibly get, and because of such a short rush distance, there tends to be the ability to get your overlord there before they would get any sizable army out. Now, we are getting a sentry, so he is going to be playing it pretty defensively. You will see some good sentry usage against my roaches. Now, I should be have just spawned the 2 overlords I was talking about right there, and now I'll be getting my first roach spawn. Now, I saw exactly what he has, which is just zealots, and I know that his stalker is going to be coming along the way, and he is researching warp gates. Now that he saw my Roach Warren, he decides to go robotics facility, which means that he went from a fast cybernetics core into a quick Robotech build. I do not have that scouted, and the player put it in a very good position all the way back here, so it is, going to be very hard for me to figure out if that's, if that's the way he's going. So I'm going to play fairly aggressive with my roaches because last time I checked, he only had 2 zealots, and having 4 roaches against 2 zealots and a stalker, I'm not really worried about that. However, Stevotron does have a sentry, and you're going to see right here when he plops down this force field in just a second, he's going to trap my roach, which is very smart, and he's going to get the kill off successfully. We traded 1 roach for 1 zealot, pretty even trade, and now that I see he has a stalker, I want to back off. Now, you want to continue your roach production for a while, but you'll notice that I'm already teching up to a layer. Now that I've survived the initial engagement, all I have to worry about is stalkers, because most players will transition into Foregate or mass stalkers. I was not expecting Robo back here. He is training in Immortal, and unfortunately, he invested so heavily in his tech that I've actually broken through his terribly placed force field. That was a very bad placed force field, not as good as his last one. And almost get the stalker kill off, but as you can see, he's just slightly faster. So he pulls all of his drones off the line. And at this point, I do see he has an immortal, so I do know that he has his robotics facility back there. So I'm gonna try to do as much damage as possible and hopefully get off the kill, which I did, and then try to get a sentry kill. And he blocks me off very smart. So some nice micro plays here from Stevotron. We do have another gateway coming out. You do notice I have two queens, one that I'm using for creep tumors to expand my creep highway, and the other one I'm using to spawn larvae. At this point, I know that I'm in a good position, and I'm going to go ahead and get a spire. I know that if a player is going robo, that I will need somehow to counter the Colossus. So your choice is going to be either a spire, or if you want to use corruptors. I decided to do that because I saw he didn't have that many gateways, so I didn't feel that stalkers were going to be that much of an issue at this point. And then I usually immediately get my Hydralisk Den right afterwards. The important thing to note here is just the build times. The build time of the Hydralisk Den is considerably faster than the Spire. I also thought he might have been going quick Void Rays, and if he sends in one Void Ray, just a queen with transfusion, two queens with enough energy would be able to take out two Void Rays pretty easily. Now, I am going to be spamming a little bit of Zerglings. I do know that he now has Immortals and that he now has Stalkers. Zerglings are fairly substantial counter, fairly good counter to those units, and so I do want to get a little bit of that with my extra minerals, and meanwhile I'm saving up some gas for my Hydras. And here comes a big spawn of Overlords because I'm at max supply, and I want to train up enough units to be able to keep my first natural expansion fairly saturated. Now he's sending his observer over. I actually did see this observer eventually move in my base, and at this point, after I get a few Hydralisks, you should be morphing your Overseer cocoon, and hopefully, you know, if he's silly enough to leave his observer there, you're going to find it, as you're going to see he's going to walk right into my trap. Going back to his base, he is getting a robotics bay. I believe he should be upgrading this, or at least getting a Colossus fairly soon. And there goes his observer in just a quick second once I get my Overseer down there. And there we go. So with this Overseer, what you're going to want to do is you want to take him and you want to delay the Colossus from coming out as long as possible. So you should take your Overseer and fly the safest route possible, and then use the Contaminate ability down here. Now I have a fairly decent sized army. I have a few leftover roaches. I have some speedlings, which I did decide to get the speedling upgrade, and I also have the Hydralisk upgrade. One of the things that he could have done better here was, you never really want to have all your forces sitting right here. Try to keep them a little bit back, because now I knew exactly what he had going for him. I also have a fairly substantial economic advantage against him right now. Quit checking over at APM. Yeah, nothing special. Going back to income, I do kind of have a substantial advantage on him right now because I do have this expansion up. So I'm just going to keep on producing as much as I can. This drone is fail. So of course, everyone makes mistakes, so we'll just pretend that guy's not there, shall we? But I do feel that I have a substantial force to contain him, and I was considering maybe maybe being stupid and attacking that just to be able to get up here and maybe expand right next to him. But yeah, I kind of quickly realized, hey Dave, that's the wrong way to go. That does not lead into his base. So I am sending a few Zerglings around the map.